What fate awaits Newcastle? The most significant alteration to the Wasps starting lineup is at fly half, where Jimmy Gopperth replaces Danny Cipriani, whose rush of blood at Toulouse last weekend almost undid an otherwise flawless away performance. Gopperth's switch from fullback means there's a route back for Rob Miller, while Frank Halai is also included. Up front, half the pack is changed. After a week back in the old job, Ashley Johnson moves to hooker. Alex Reader, Marty Moore, Kernan Mile and Guy Thompson come in. Well, Newcastle appear to have turned a corner this season, though this is a proper test. The two Michaels, or Mikes, Young and Delaney, are a very strong halfback pairing. Outside them is a Puma and the former Wasp, Dominic Waldock. Wasps will be hoping to exploit a couple of perceived weaknesses in the front five, where experience at this level is a bit thin on the ground. Look out for Callum Chick at number 8. He's just 19 and a world champion with England's under-20s in the summer. Well, there's certainly some very interesting head-to-heads to focus on. In at the deep end goes Callum Chick for Newcastle. His opposite number is Nathan Hughes. If reputations count for anything, you'd fancy Wasps have a major advantage in the front five. Let's move on to the backs. Two New Zealanders wear 10 jerseys, though just the Falcon, Mike Delaney, is an All Black. You can be certain those Wasp wings will get a decent run today. I wonder how much ball Sinotti and Watson will see, though. That'll certainly be interesting to see. And there's no doubt that Wasps will be looking to cut off those two wings, who, if they do get the ball in hand, are capable of doing some real damage. And that has been a feature of Newcastle's play this season, playing with so much more confidence when you consider where they've been in recent seasons, essentially fighting to avoid relegation. Well, they find themselves pretty much in the top half these days. 3 wins from 6, 2 narrow defeats, and of course, perhaps the most significant result of all was that win at Gloucester, which beat a long drought away from Kingston Park. Well, there you can see those masks and what have you, I'm sure, just out for the weekend. Halloween approaching. And here comes Dean Richards. A man who never needs to wear a mask. He's a man whose thoughts on life you always know. Dyer Young. Well, Dyer Young, he's doing so well these days at Wasps. He's been through thick and thin. He's stuck with the club. If you consider that over the course of the last 3 or 4 years, how close did they come to going to the wall at one point? And then there was the uncertainty of the move away from Adams Park up to, from High Wycombe up to Coventry. Well, his persistence has certainly paid, along with a number of members of the squad. And now we see Wasps among the big spenders in the Aviva Premiership. They've got a fair amount of talent waiting in the wings. Bear in mind, Kirtley Beale is here, but sidelined with that knee injury, which he sustained during the Northern Hemisphere summer. And Billy LaRue, the the Springbok fullback, waiting to arrive in the new year in February when he comes over from the Cannon Eagles from Japan. So the scrap for places will be very competitive indeed, and I know that maintaining that level of competition has been so important for Dyer Young, keeping players on their toes. That's perhaps what he's doing to Danny Cipriani today. John Wells, former Leicester man, alongside Dave Walder. And here, coming out, are the men from the northeast. Callum Chick, the third man out there, a junior world champion just a matter of weeks ago. There he is, actually captained the England under-20s during last season's Six Nations. There is the leader of the Newcastle side, Will Welch. Well, no introduction really required. The men led out by Joe Launchbury. Jimmy Gopperth, after a spell with 12 on his back at inside centre, fullback last week at the Stade Ernest Vallon, well, he gets to wear his preferred number. And Christian Wade, well, He is at home wherever he is on the pitch, particularly with the ball in hand and if a little bit of space is offered to him.
Great Carl Trevor, Eastman, yeah, got you.
Certainly at home now in the West Midlands. He's made quite an impact when he's been given a chance. The referee today, there he is, Craig Maxwell-Keys, his 23rd Premiership game in charge.